Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can work with some transparent gradients in Photoshop to get effects that you may not otherwise believe that you can achieve. Before we get started with this tutorial, let's have a look and see what it is that we're trying to achieve. This is an image of a tram in San Francisco along the Embarcadero, and this is the original and this is the edited image. And what I've done is added a vignette to the image using a gray to transparent gradient, and I'm going to show you why those sorts of gradients are particularly handy. There's also another effect that we're going to create here with a difference cloud effect, and what I've done is built up the layers here again using color to transparent gradients. So we'll see how to create that effect as well. But let's start with our image of San Francisco tram. I'm going to just trash that layer, and now let's see how we would achieve that effect. I'm going to right click on the background layer and duplicate this layer. So I have two versions of the image, and I'm going to set the blend mode for this topmost layer to multiply because that darkens the image. So that's effectively the darkening that I'm going to use for my vignette, but I don't want it in the middle of the image. So I'm going to add a mask to this top layer by clicking on the top layer and click the Add Layer Mask icon at the foot of the layers palette. That adds a white filled mask. I'm going to set black as my foreground color, make sure my mask is selected, and press Alt Backspace on the PC, Option Delete on the Mac, and that fills the mask with black, effectively removing the effect of adding that duplicate layer in multiply blend mode. So we're sort of back to square one. But what I want to do is to use gray or a sort of white color here to build back in the vignette. And I'm going to do that using a gradient. So I'm going to click on the gradient tool here. And up here in the top corner of the tool options bar, I get a selector for my gradient. Now there's always a foreground to background gradient, and there's always a black and white one. And there's always here a foreground to transparent one. And you might be tempted to use the black to white gradient. I'm going to select it now and show you why you wouldn't use it. This is a black to white gradient. So if, for example, I set it to radial, it will do as it says and drop in a black to white gradient. But whenever I add another one of these gradients, you can see that it's replacing the existing one. So I'm not getting them adding to each other, they're doing a straight out replacement. Let's just go back to filling that with black, and let's see how different it is if I use the black or foreground to transparent gradient. I'm going to click on that, and this time let's make the foreground color white. So I'm just going to press D to reset the default colors. So this gradient is still foreground to transparent, it's just that foreground is now white, so it's working white to transparent. Now let's see what happens with the mask selected when I drop in these radial gradients. See what's happening here in the mask preview here, you can see that we're actually adding multiple gradients. These gradients are sort of cumulative because what we're doing is we're dropping in white to transparent instead of white to black. So they're only filling up in the area that is white through to where the transparency starts, and then nothing else is being added. So we can add this gradient in ways that we can't do if we're using a black to white gradient. Okay, let's go back and refill this gradient here with black. And I'm going to this time use the linear gradient. I'm going to make sure that white is my color, and now I can just come in and start building in the gradient where I want it to be. And you can see that because this layer is a multiply blend mode layer, this is adding the vignette back in, but I can be really careful about where I want this vignette to be, and I can put it exactly where I want it and nowhere that I don't want it. Because we're building this mask up using a white to transparent gradient instead of a white to black gradient. So you can see how that would work. Now let's go to a new file. So I'm just going to choose File New. We're just going to have a look at this effect where we're actually painting on layers this way. So now I'm going to add a difference cloud. Now I just wanted to show you something about difference cloud filter that I discovered this morning that I didn't know before, and it really makes sense. I'm going to go to Filter, Render, and Difference Clouds, and you'll see that there's a yellow. Now the reason why they're yellow is because blue is the foreground color. If we made the foreground color, for example, green, and then go back and add difference clouds in, I'm just pressing Alt Command Z to undo that. Let's go back and add difference clouds. This time they're going to be a sort of magenta color, and the reason is because they're a difference cloud. They're going to be the color opposite of the color that you have selected here. So now if we set it to black and white, again I'm going to undo this, and now if we do difference clouds, they're going to be black and white clouds because black and white are the opposite of each other. So now let's add a brand new layer, and I'm going to start painting in color. So let's just go and get some color. Let's go and get a blue here as our foreground color. I'm going to set the blend mode of this new layer to color. I'm going to select my gradient tool, and this time I'm going to use the radial gradient, and again it'll be preset to the option that I chose last time, which is this foreground to transparent. Now when I start adding color, you'll see that because this is a color blend layer, we're just colorizing the layer underneath. So let's add another layer, again with color. Again, let's go and get a color to use. I'm going to choose a sort of dark purple here, and I'm still painting with this gradient. So what we're doing is colorizing the layer underneath, but we're building it up with mini gradients because we're using a foreground to transparent color. Anywhere where the gradient is not applied will be transparent. Now the difference would be, let's go and get a foreground to white gradient, and let's apply that, and that would just slop a gradient right in the middle of it. Anytime I go to drag another gradient out, it's totally replaced. This is not the kind of tool that we want in this situation. What I want to do to color this background in an attractive way is to be using this foreground to transparent gradient so that I can get an interesting effect in the work that I'm doing. So I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more of my video tutorials on this channel. Consider subscribing to the channel so that you'll be alerted when new videos are released. Visit my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, and a whole lot more.